video for HVAC plant, how to get the HVAC plant. And so what the things, this is a plant we have, what the things we have to cover here. So this is a plant I have to cover from here to here in this area. So what is the things here I will tell you. This is EHU supplying to this area, and this is a return EHU is here. So this EHU supply, you know, this before we discussed with the air grill diffuser. So now we have a different type of air grill diffuser. For example, I have to tell you, this is jet type, or you say jet diffusers or nozzle or eyeball diffusers. So why we installed to the this diffuser, and what is the criteria to installation of this. So I have to try to cover the that things. So this is, you say, this is eyeball, you can say eyeball diffusers in HVAC, you can say as well nozzle diffusers and jet diffusers. So mostly we are saying this diffuser to the jet diffusers. So first we have to start to have, this is supplying here, supply is coming here. So you see here 900 by 400 FA from above, this is coming here, this is going here, this is 7 lines, you have to see this is okay, this duct is going here. So after that they have to water to the two parts. So you can see here, this is 750 by 350, this one 750 by 350, you can see this one. Okay, so after that this is the flexible pipe is coming, and after that the jet diffusers or nozzle diffuser, or you say this is eyeball diffuser installed here. So what is the criteria to install for this diffusers? So if you have a roof plan like that, the roof height is approximately 3 meters, so you can install to the simple diffusers. This is like that, grill type diffuser or linear diffuser like that. If you have a more than 3 meters, like 4 meter 4.5 meter or 6 meter, so if you are, for example, this is a level is different, this is the first floor, this is open area, I will show you here, this is open area. Okay, so this level, the roof may be here a 6 meter, but here roof is the only 3 meters, because this is, you know, main hall type, this is open. So we are not installing a simple type of diffusers, because, you know, if you are installing here diffuser 3 meters, so it is easy to get the air down. But we are using this maybe in 6 meter, the height will be the 6 meter or 5.5 meter like that. So we simple be using this diffuser here. So what will happen, air will be not go down, or the you know, cooling will be not, you will not get the cooling in this area. So for this purpose we using here a jet diffuser types. Jet diffuser type is very simple, this is so simple like that. This is like simple this diffuser, but what is the function for this? This is inlet of air. For example, inlet of air is a bigger, and outlet of air where the discharge will be the very narrow, like, you know, very small narrow nozzle types. So this flexible, for example, here coming 200 like that, so that will be connecting in 200, and we will discharge side, you know, you will find to the 60 or 70. So the pressure of the air, it will be go down, you know, so they will be, we will maintain the cooling in this area. So I hope you understand the jet diffuser's function. So I will be explain one time more. So this is jet diffuser function is like that. If you are, your height of the roof or slab is more than 3 meter 3.5 or 4 meter or 5 meter, so you cannot get this area to cool. So in that case, we using as per SMACNA, we using this, or as per ASHRAE, we using this area using in this area jet diffusers. We call to the jet diffuser. The jet diffuser function is so simple. Inlet is coming of the air will be 200 like that, but outlet will be 60 or 70. So it will be automatically pressurized. You know, this air will be pressurized, or it will be go to the down very far as compared to this. If you compare this one, this is 200 and 200 outlet, so it will be coming down here. If here is 200 inlet and 60 or 70 this is outlet, so it will be going down. So this is a function for jet diffusers. So simple. Here this is here, after this reducing, this is 750, there is a 700 ducts. So this is see here, liter per second they're saying here. What is a liter per second they're saying? Liter per second they're saying here as 116 liter per second, this one, and this 700 by 750. So we have also volume damper here. We are not showing here in drawing, maybe you're missing this one. This is the volume damper here as well. So this is here, this is the different elevation here and different elevation here. So that's why we provide to the simple diffusers, and here is the jet diffusers. So you can see here the different. So this is volume damper. Volume damper, what is the function of volume damper? We have to balance the air. For example, this is going here, there are 600 CFM, or we need 200 here, so 600 will be going here. We have to divert the 400 here, so we have to adjust here the volume damper, and only the 200 will be allowed to come here. So maybe the first time that people is watching my video, so that's why I'm clearing the concept for volume dampers. So this is the reduce of size as per the calculation, and then this is a diffuser we are using here. Diffusers, so in HVAC you see the diffuser and diffusers. So this is, you know, this is overlapping attack here, so we show it dotted here, after that is going here, same like that. So what we have to do with the duct, we have to install. After that we have to check the installation, there is the strength is okay, or the supports are as per standard, as per this magma, or as per HVAC, and then we will be check the alignment of this, alignment of duct is okay, and check the elevation. In elevation, the levels, inward levels, so from the finished floor level, how much the level is here. For example, here this is 3 meter slab, or maximum 2.5 is a ceiling, so it must be above the ceiling, so we check the level as well. So we will check the level is above the ceiling should be, and we have a 10 centimeter more to above the ceiling, so we have to install the insulation in the future like that. So because why we have to install the insulation, because this is a condensated, you know, this cool air is coming here, the condensation maybe, and will be the maybe the water will be dropped to the ceiling and the damage. So that's why we have to put a insulation, and then as per the standard, how much duct size and duct size, how much duct size available, as per the duct size we put the insulation sizes in the schedule. So this is insulation. And before the installation, after installation, we have to test the smoke test or light test. So there is no leakage like that. For example, this is coming here 2000 CFM, or there is some leakage here, for example. So it will be, efficiency will be, you know, down with the leakage. So maybe the 300 will be missing here, 200 missing here. So up to here, only 1500 is coming. So we have to take care about the leakage. So that's why we took the inspection, light test inspection, or we have to take a light test or a smoke test. How we have to do the smoke test, I mentioned several times before in the drawings. So in the smoke test, this is very simple. There is smoke emitters like that, smoke emitters, or you say smoke chocks available in the market. So they will be keeping after lit this smoke chalk or smoke, then they will keep inside the duct, and they put the blower like that, so it will be, if any leakage, it will be come out the smoke. So it means it's not coming out, it means it's okay. If coming out, it means there is the leakage. So when doing of the smoke test, we have to put a adhesive or like, you know, something to close this smoke leakage. So after that, this solution is complete. We have to do the insulation. After insulation, so insulation, after that we'll be going for testing and commissioning after that. So hope you understand this video and you're ducting and everything. So kindly subscribe my channel if you didn't subscribe. This is AfreenAli. Thank you. I will bring the more video for you for HVAC learning. Thank you. Bye bye.